So I think what we'll do, most of the people around the room, but I'm going to start with our vice president, who is our vice president. Sure. There he is. And maybe start with Mike, and we'll just go around and just you name your position, and then we'll ask these folks to go back and have a good day, and we're going to discuss other issues.
Thank you, Mr. President. The greatest privilege of my life to serve as Vice President and President, keeping the word of the American people, assembling a team that's bringing real change, real prosperity, real strength.
I'm President. It's great to be here and celebrate this group. We are receiving a huge thanks to the rest of the support.
And also the other heads of the five families from New York, New Jersey.
If you haven't seen The Godfather lately, I invite you to read James Comey's description of his January 27th dinner with President Trump in the White House green room. It reads like a loyalty ritual where the mob boss demands of anyone seeking his favor that he first genuflect down to him, vow his undying loyalty, and call him Godfather.
I'm a businessman, first foremost.
I would just add that, of course, there needs to be a degree of independence between DOJ, FBI, and a White House,
absolutely right,
and a line of communications established.
Ban,
the president knew it. He's new to
never let him see
so
tweet.
He probably wasn't
they always say never let him see
long-running
remember, no one ever said that Harry Truman didn't have a temper, but that Ronald Reagan, a long memory. They just preferred giving their critics hell. They're telling them to go to hell. Just because your own critics never thought that you'd make it to the White House does not
that
me.
Speculation was
you shouldn't listen to those who want you to try to succeed in the White House. They're not the problem, Mr. President. Like I said, these days, you are.
I don't recall any. I don't recall it. I don't recall. I don't recall. I don't not recall. I don't know.